Hello wildlife lovers and welcome back to episode 3 of Thikala Wildlife Series from Discover Wild Paws. As visible in the video, it's a chilling winter morning here in Thikala and we are ready for our safari number 2. In the previous episode, we met the host of Thikala, the grassland Wali tigress. We hope that you have already watched episode 1 and 2 of this series. Before we begin this episode, we request you to subscribe to our channel Discover Wild Paws. This keeps us motivated to bring to you the best wildlife content from across the world. Before the first light of the sun hits the ground of Thikala, the jeeps get ready to wander the jungle and find the tiger. The good thing about Thikala is that majority of the crowd here are passionate wildlife lovers. Or else it is hard to wake up this early in December for a wildlife safari in the mountains of Uttarakhand. One after the other, the jeeps line up. The people standing on the left are safari guides and each sit on one jeep. As soon as the gates open, all these will go into different directions. Early morning is a great time to find a tiger, as it is considered to be prime time for big cat movement. So never be late on a morning safari. Many times, only the first couple of jeeps are able to see the tiger. The previous evening, we had seen a tigress near the grasslands. So we decided to check a different area of Thikala early morning. So a lot of jeeps turned right towards the grasslands. We turned left towards the Sambar Road. This name Sambar Road is because of the obvious reason that a lot of sambars are seen in this area. But we were not here to see the sambars. We were here to find Paro and her sub-adult daughters. With this much fog, our visibility was low. So finding a tiger in this light is extremely difficult. Even if you find one, it is hard to capture on camera. Needless to say, we were shivering in the cold, but our enthusiasms were high. Even though we were a little less hopeful of seeing a tiger at dawn, our safari guide was super confident. This is another blessing with Thikala, that all the safari guides here are passionate, experienced tiger trackers. And he was not wrong. There were no jeeps around, and suddenly he saw something out far in the river. It was a tiger. One of Paro's cub was crossing the Ram Ganga River early in the morning. With no jeeps around, this was a unique sighting for us. The sighting was like watching a movie. It seemed so unreal. Are we actually watching a tiger at dawn crossing a river? We just could not believe our eyes. Paro, the other famous tigress of Thikala, is a bold queen of Corbett. She has two surviving daughters from her latest litter. This was one of the two. Paro and the two cubs have been known to cross Ram Ganga River quite a few times over a month. But it is not easy to find them in such a dense forest. Because of the fog, at one point it seemed as if the tiger is bathing in the hot water spring. Seeing tiger at this hour of the morning is not preferable for wildlifers, as it is difficult to capture good images on camera in low light. But we had no complaints. Our guide told us that these two cubs are so bold and daring that one day they were both chasing down an adult elephant. Imagine how confident they are of their strength. Anyway, as she disappeared into the grasslands on the other side of the river, we waited there for a while. As the fog slowly cleared and the sun came up, Sambar Road changed its colors. Now we wanted to see her again in this light to capture her true beauty. We still had lots of time left, so we thought it's better to wait there for some more time, in case she comes back, or if we could find her sister or mother nearby. And slowly, other jeeps started coming too, but unfortunately, they were too late. All the jeeps got the news of our sighting, and now everyone was hopeful that this is their best chance to spot the tiger. But we had already seen her, so we thought of taking a bit of risk. There is a wooden bridge that connects this side of Dekala to the other side of the river. The bridge was supposed to open that morning, so we thought we will cross the bridge and find her on the other side. So we left all the jeeps behind and rushed towards the Ram Ganga bridge. There was a bit more fog closer to the other side, and because of rain, the holes on the road were filled with water. One thing you should all be mindful of is that the morning safaris are extremely cold in Tikala, especially in winters. So we advise you to wear multiple layers of clothing and carry thin blankets. Also, have something to keep ears and hands covered. As we reached near the bridge, we saw a gathering of jeeps. These ones already came here when they heard that the tigress had crossed the river. But we were all disappointed to see that the bridge was still closed. In about 30 minutes from this moment, the bridge was opened by the forest department, and we went to the other side, which is called Par. Did we find Paro and her cubs again? Or did we return empty-handed? Stay tuned to find out in episode 4 of this series. And if you have not already, please subscribe to our channel, Discover Wild Paws.